Mercurial mercenaries. A long time ago, when I was discussing King Gizzard and Lizards, I was talking about the fact that the first album I ever owned, and one of my favourite albums, is Fragile by Yes. And some of you guys, specifically Ali Bad, who says, if you haven't seen What's in My Bag with King Gizz, Stu actually picks up the same Yes album and said it's one of his favourite albums of all time. That's one of those coincidence things, yeah, I suppose. But you want to see some more coincidence, my mercenaries? You want to see some more coincidence? I'll show you coincidence. Here's King Gizz in What's in My Bag, alright?
Hey, I'm Cook. I'm Joe.
Hey, I'm Eric.
I'm Michael.
Amber. I'm Stu.
Gotta say, I like Eric's style straight away. This is Stu saying, I need to do more reaction videos about King Gizz and Lizard. So, they go through various bits and pieces here and they talk about what their favourite albums are. And on the whole, they tend to pick out, I would say obscure stuff. I tried to get into Guided by Voices.
First one,
very lo-fi.
Lee Hazelwood soundtrack, which as soon as I got off the rack, Andy already bagged me out. Cause
Bono wears sunglasses indoors. Eric wears a hat. But it looks a little bit like Where's Wally? A little bit? In a good way.
It's like a real...
Let's get to Stu when he talks about it, right? Here we go.
I got a t-shirt because I stink like shit.
It stinks
like... My girlfriend actually introduced me to Yes. So it's good because she can wear that too. This is an amazing record, Fragile.
This has been with me.
So it was sort of like...
For my whole life, my mercenaries, pretty much.
Metal, I guess. And then through that... kind of going to bands like Tool and
stuff. And then he moves on. Like, but he mentions Yes, right?
Like,
fine.
Comes back to bands like Yes.
Get on to the other coincidence.
Even though they weren't hugely made, they influenced a lot of that sort of stuff. Everything's all related, I think. Definitely.
We move on. Let's just listen to Yes for a little bit. Get me a copyright strike from King Gizz and Yes.
Really kooky.
The second coincidence. Where I think Stu starts to talk about his lyrical influences. I'll find it. Calm down. This is doable, my mercenaries. It's Boxing Day. What else would you rather be doing on Boxing Day? We could do an unboxing. Do you want to do an unboxing?
Craft stories.
So he's obviously into H.P. Lovecraft,
kind
right?
Of gruesome and dark, and I like that sort of thing. H.P. Lovecraft is one of my favourite authors, and it's kind of good to have all of these bundled up together, so there's some sort of classics of his.
You can see the artwork from the King Gizz covers, can't you? If you look through that again.
I love Lovecraft stories because it's kind of gruesome and dark, and I like that.
Jason.
H.P. Lovecraft.
Galea.
One of my favourite authors.
I'm pronouncing that right?
It's kind of good to
he's
have.
He's got avid influence there as well, hasn't he?
Bundled up together.
Hang on. So there's. We're talking about the macabre, the worshipping of the devil.
I actually got a whole stack of books. I got Beowulf because
it's got Beowulf.
Kind of like
first poem, really, isn't it?
Classic, and I've never read it. This is
always good to have something you don't read.
Novel. Arthur C. Clarke.
I've got plenty of stuff I don't read.
Potentially wrote the screenplay for the.
I've got loads of videos I don't watch. I need to watch all these videos, my mercenaries.
Like most people would know if they've ever seen it, it's kind of deliberately vague. And it's a beautiful film. It's an amazing film. But this is, I've heard, more in depth and kind of like explains some parts of the story.
He's heard it.
I've always wanted to read this.
I see.
A collection of H.P. Lovecraft
I see.
Stories.
He's not saying that it is his favourite book. He's gone into a record shop. He's gone into a shop. King Gizzard and Lizard Izzard go shopping at Amoeba Music in Los Angeles. So he's chosen to buy the book so he can explore it. I get it. Fine. Watch this one, mercenaries. This is for coincidence, right?
Okay, Dick, in your life.
Here we go. Here we go for coincidence, my mercenaries.
Satanic.
So he likes this book or buys this book or whatever. He's into the idea of Flowers from Hell, a satanic reader, edited by Nicholas Schreck. This is a book which features Milton and Edgar Allan Poe and various, as it says, a satanic, I don't know why I did that, a satanic reader, okay? Look at the picture, my mercenaries. Look at this picture, my mercenaries. So coincidence number one, when it comes to King Gizzard and Lizzie Dizzard, right? Coincidence number one, right? Look at the picture, my mercenaries, on the screen now. The screen, right? Look at the screen. Look at that! My mercenaries. I was watching this video because Ali Bad said you should watch What's In My Bag of King Gizz, which I did. Yeah? And, yeah. All I can say there is stew. And, you know, your guys will say, well, you can't talk about stew. Who are you, Mercurial number six, compared to the godlike genius of stew? Well, listen. I think I probably owned and liked this album before Stew was born. In fact, not probably, I did. So, all right. But this album's been on my wall for a while now, and if you look back, I've done a review of it. It's called Blessed Are the Sick by Morbid Angel. My mercenaries. Yes, it is indeed. The book that Stew picks has got the cover art from Morbid Angel's Blessed of the Sick. Two coincidences in one video, my mercenaries. And also, I have been known to wear a black woolly hat every so often. And glasses. Alright? So, there you go. That's your day of coincidence. Well, your few minutes of coincidence with the Mercurial number 6 on Boxing Day! On Boxing Day. I hope you had a good Christmas. And, cheers. Over and out.